to everyone. We're learning today Zera Shimshon, Parashat, Vayigash, Letter Tet. This shiur is being sponsored by Molo Yosef Ben Shlomo and his family Eliyahu, Leilu Nishmat, their father Shlomo Ben Ima Shalom, and also shiur is sponsored by Shlomo Ben Yuchoy Boruch. Hashem should give him atzlacha, panasat tova, refuah shlema to his wife, and refuah shlema to Chol Amo Yisrael. And also, today's shiur is for Hatzlacha, Molo Aaron Ben Abo, Molo Menashe Ben Israel Chai, and Gadol Ben Moshe. And Kol Chol Amo Yisrael V'cheni Ratzon V'nomad Amen. Page Tav Lamed Zayin, 437. Pasuk. Before Yaakov Avinu went to Egypt, what happened? Brothers came to Mitzrayim, to Egypt, and Yosef HaTzadik said, I'm Yosef. Brothers didn't believe him until he showed them that he has Brit and he has Kiddushat Brit. And Yosef HaTzadik showed that he's holding the wholeness of his Brit Milah. Then brothers believed him. They died. Why? Because they sold him and now they embarrassed from this. So our Chachamim say, if Yosef, the youngest brother in the family, brothers were embarrassed in front of him, they died from shame, how much more person will be embarrassed in front of Hashem for all his actions that he's doing, thinking nobody sees me. So therefore, Yosef and his sons, they were walking around making those dead people alive by saying Hashem's name. Brothers became alive. Yosef said, guys, don't worry. You sold me, that's not you. It's all from God. Happened from Hashem. Then he said, okay, let's not waste time. Go bring my father to Egypt, because the whole world is dying from drought. There's no food, hunger everywhere. I don't want my father to die. Go bring the family. So Yosef sent chariots. Yaakov Avinu saw chariots. Chariot is in Hebrew, agala. He remembered, oh, last thing I learned with Yosef, egla rufa. So now, also, he's sending me chariots, agala. Yosef still remembers what we learned. Comes out, even though Yosef in Mitzrayim for 22 years, he didn't forget who he was. He still learns Torah. Now, I want to go and see him. But Yaakov Avinu was scared. You're living in Eretz Israel, you cannot live Holy Land. So he went and he brought korbanot. He brought sacrifice to Hashem. When he brought sacrifice, it says, sacrifice to the God of his father Yitzchak. Who's the first Jew in the Torah? Abraham Avinu. So why does it say to the God of his father Yitzchak and Abraham? Now, with this question, we could begin. Look inside. Pasuk. Vayisbach zevachim lelohe aviv Yitzchak. And Yaakov Avinu brought sacrifice to the God of his father Yitzchak. Pirish Rashi. Rashi is saying something unbelievable. You have in your house father and grandfather. Your father tells you, bring me tea. Your grandfather tells you, bring me coffee. Who do you serve first?
Father.
Who do you serve first?
Father.
Huh?
Father.
Not grandfather? Isn't your father has to be taking care of your grandfather first? Huh?
If the water is your father, he'll give it to him alone.
Look what Rashi says. Pirush Rashi. Mikan. From here we learn. Aviv yoter mikvod zekeno. Ad kan leshono. From here we learn that you respect your father more than your grandfather. The father's honor coming more than grandfather's. Makshim ha'olam. The world is asking a question. What did Lashe feel to say, oh, from here we learn, you respect your father more than grandfather. Just because it says, God of his father Yitzchak, and not Abraham, from here you learn, you respect father more than grandfather? What Rashi was bothered with? The Dilma asas vachim leelohe aviv Yitzchak mipnei shehaya aviv v'lo mipnei kavod. Maybe he said, I'm bringing sacrifice for my God of my father Yitzchak just because his father is Yitzchak, not because of respect. How do you know from, because it says Avram, because he didn't say Avram, just said Yitzchak, it means honor. Maybe he just wants to say it for my father. When Hillel Omar seems to see, the Shapir seems to say, the Shapir Ochiach Rashi, the Chayav Adam. It's really true that Rashi is teaching us that father's respect comes before grandfather's. Person is obligated to respect his father more than grandfather. Mishum de kashe le de hacha ad rabbi Yaakov de hacha ad rabbi Yaakov lo haya lo lizbach ela davka le lo Avraham. Really, it's true. It's even opposite, even worse. Yaakov Avinu should have bring sacrifice for God of Avraham. Sha'arei ata haya olech le Mitzrayim להתחיל השיבוד שגזר הקדוש ברוך הוא עם אברהם ידוע תדע. Tell me one thing. Because of who did we go down to Mitzrayim? To be 400 years slaves there. Avraham Avinu. So if Yaakov Avinu is beginning to go down to Mitzrayim because of Avraham Avinu, say the God of Abraham. Why say God of Yitzchak? Everyone understands what I'm talking about? It is clear or no? Yaakov Avinu is going down to Mitzrayim. He's scared. He says, let me bring korban sacrifice to Hashem to get my permission to go down. He brings sacrifice. Hashem says, don't worry, go. But whose name did he use to bring sacrifice? God of my father? Yitzchak. Why didn't he say God of my father? Abraham. That is the question. What he should have said? Abraham, why? Because of Abraham we went down to Egypt. We are becoming slaves in Islam because of who? Abraham. Abraham said, Hashem, can you give me a hint? How it's going to be good for my children? Hashem says, you're asking for a hint? 400 years your sons will be slaves in Islam. Remember that? Because of Abraham we're becoming slaves. So say God of Abraham. I say God of Yitzchak. That's the question. ויעקב קודם שהלך למצרים עשה זבחים כדי להתפלל לקדוש ברוך הוא שיוצא משם. And Yaakov Avinu, before he was going down to Mitzrayim, he brought down sacrifices so Hashem should give him permission and help him to go out from Egypt. כמו שאמרנו זאל. As our Chachamim said, it's brought down in Zohar, Parashat Beshalach, page 53a. Anochi Ered imcha Mitzrayma. God said Avraham to Yaakov, don't worry Yaakov, go down to Egypt. I will go down with you. I will go down with you to Mitzrayim. Ma'anuchi alche gamalo, and I will go up with you from there also. What does that mean? Yaakov himself turned to 600,000. Guys, you with me? Yaakov alone, four wives, 12 sons. Yaakov himself is like Hashem's name, Yud Kei Vav Kei. Oh, Aleph, Daled, Nun, Yud. Four letters, Aleph, Daled, Nun, Yud. You write Aleph, three letters. Aleph, Lamed, Pei, Daled, Daled, Lamed, Tav, Nun, Nun, Vav, Nun, Yud, Yud, Vav, Daled. Four letters, three words on each letter, comes out to be 12. These 12, each one has its own 2-3 letters, comes out 50. 50 to 70. This is why Yaakov Avinu goes along with his family, and they are 70 souls in Mitzrayim, right? 70 turns out to be 600,000 souls, right? This is how Yaakov Avinu multiplied in Mitzrayim. Hashem said, don't worry. You go, I'll go with you, and I'll come out with you from there also after 210 years, right? Okay, ואנוכי הלכה גם הלא כמו שהבטיח לאברהם וגם את הגוי אשר יעבוד הוא דן אנוכי. Hashem gives guarantee to Yaakov Avinu as he gave guarantee to Avraham Avinu. Avraham Avinu was depressed. He said, my children will go 400 years to Egypt for no reason. He got upset. Hashem said, don't worry. The nation, which is Egypt, that will be torturing your children, I will torture them, God said. Hashem said, Hashem gave promise to Avraham Avinu. Not only that, after that, Avraham, your children will come out from Egypt with a great wealth. So now, even more proof that Yaakov Avinu should say, this sacrifice for my father, Avraham. Because God guaranteed to Avraham. Why Yaakov Avinu bringing sacrifice for his father, Yitzchak, and not Avraham? We got question good, solid? Mm-hmm. Next piece. Ella, but v'adai mukhlachim anu lomar, we are forced to say she'asa ken bishvil shechayav adam b'chod aviv. Why he did that? Because when you have your father, your grandfather, whose respect come first? Your father's. Closer to you. V'asa lo kavod zeh leitpalel HaKadosh Baruch Hu she'ifdem min hagalut b'zchut Yitzchak. He prayed to Hashem so Hashem should save him from the exile of Egypt because of his father Yitzchak. Ho'il shem imenu itchil hagalut. Why? Because we supposed to be in Egypt 400 years. We were in Egypt 210 years. Where is 190 years? What happened to 190 years? 190 years, Hashem said, I'll be nice to you and I'll start from the birth of Yitzchak. Yitzchak Avinu was born 190 years before Yaakov is going down to Mitzrayim. How do we know this? Because how old was Yitzchak Avinu when Yaakov and Esau were born? He was 60 years old. Yitzchak had Akedah, how old was? 37. Akedah 37, he got married after 3 years, 40. 20 years they didn't have children, 60. So now, Yaakov Avinu was 117 years old when he came down to Mitzrayim. Remember that? There's 3 years gap from Yitzchak Avinu Akedah until Yitzchak Avinu came back home. That 3 years gap, Yitzchak Avinu angels picked him up to Shamayim, gave him surgery and brought him down. By the time they picked him up and brought him down, 3 years passed in his life. Yitzchak Avinu did not gain that 3 years in his life. The world went 3 years forward.
He lost 3 years, man.
He did not have the 3 years. He stood on the same second, but the world went 3 years forward. Age in the world changed, but not him. So by the time Yitzchak Avinu was going down to Mitzrayim, there's many proofs to that, to what I said. Mm-hmm. Look into the Mefarshim. When I said it first time 17 years ago in Kollel, Beit Gabriel, one rabbi by the name Yosef Ben Chabib, he came up and said, wow, this is Chiddush to me. Baruch Hashem, if I can give some Chiddushim, why not? Yitzchak Avinu, from the time he was born until Yaakov went down to Mitzrayim, 190 years. 117. Right. 190 years. So 190 and 210 comes out 400. So Hashem cut off 190 years from promise that he said to Avraham Avinu that we will be 400 years in Mitzrayim. But now I don't understand one point. If the whole 400 cycle began from the birth of Yitzchak Avinu, now I understand why Yaakov Avinu says Yitzchak Avinu. What he says, I'm bringing sacrifice for God of Yitzchak. Why? Because 400 years began from when?
He started it.
He started. Yitzchak started 400 years. So he says, I need to bring for Yitzchak's name. Why? Because when the time Yitzchak was born, the 400 cycle started. הואיל שהמנו התחיל הגלות כדכתיב, כי גל יהיה זאת אחה ומיום לידתו, נשתנו 400 שנה. From the time that Yitzchak Avinu was born, that was already when 400 years were completed from Yitzchak Avinu's birth till we came out from Mitzrayim. Let's look inside and we'll go further. ועוד, turn the page on top line. And also, יש לומר שידוע שתם גלות מצרים היה ללקט כל הניצוצות. Now, this is the main reason why I invited you today to Shiur. We should know one thing. You're driving in highway. Suddenly, something wrong happens to your car. And you pull over. You pull over near gas station or something. Now you want to buy water. You buy the water, right? You check its kosher. What do you do first thing? Shakur. Question. Ask yourself a question. Why me has to be standing right near the store and making this bracha shakol? Why do I have to do it right now? Or you're supposed to be going to one hotel and you end up in a different hotel. Or you should be in hotel on the room 310 and you end up in 415. Why should you be there and not there? Any vacation you do in your life, don't forget, something has to change. Any vacation in your life, you should be sitting on the first three rows in the plane, you're sitting in the last rows. Or opposite, vice versa. Why? Because you should know this for life. You are not coming here to fulfill your pleasures. Even though you'll have some enjoyment, you are coming here to fix. Your job is collector. You're collecting lost souls that is in the world. There are many souls everywhere. In the world, wherever you travel, you go to collect those souls. Now, after this introduction, let's look inside. Ve'od, yesh lomar, she'edu she'tam galud Mitzrayim haya lelaket kohen tzotzot. Why Yaakov Avinu has to go down to Egypt? Why Yosef has to go down to Egypt? Why Jewish nation has to go down to Egypt? Because Egypt had a lot of lost sparks, and they need to go there and collect those sparks. Because of the sin of Adam Arishon, sparks of wholeness went into Egypt. It got lost there. So Yaakov Avinu is a jeweler, has to take a rock, shine it, and see which is diamond, and get it. His job is to get those sparks. And it says what? And Yosef Atzadik collected all the money there. What do you mean money? Do you really think Yosef collected money? You know how much money Yosef collected? People came to Yosef to say, we need food. He said, I'm not going to give you food, but we're going to die from hunger. He said, you don't want to die from hunger? Here, go make Brit Milah. He says, I'm going to die rather. I'm not going to do the Brit. Till tomorrow, right? Next day, he's really dying from hunger. So he goes make Brit. By the time he makes Brit Milah, Yosef gained another soul. In order to get clear, let me explain to you. Adam Arishon was not a Jew. Adam Arishon was a person. Jew goy, those days, there's no Jew goy. No Torah? Depends. Are you fear of God or no? Adam Arishon made sin with his Brit Milah. So anyone does not keep Brit Milah, he's not fixing Adam Arishon's sin. So, the generation of flood, 24,000 giants, they died because they didn't care about Brit Milah. They didn't watch the Brit Milah. They did whatever they want to do. And this is why flood came. Flood came why? Water. Not watching Brit Milah, what do? You spill water. Hashem said, you spill water, I'm going to spill you in the water and flood will come. Yosef HaTzadik said, I'm not going to let my opportunity to be lost. So he made sure everyone, whoever gets food, first gets Brit Milah. This way Yosef gets the diamonds. Today when somebody collects money for saving youth from public school, what do they say? We gotta get those gems, those diamonds. Why? Because don't look at the child who's being in the wrong spot as a child. It's a diamond. This diamond could be a world. If he gets married to a religious girl, he becomes religious, he has five kids, you saved 86 people. His grandchildren, 100 people. Great grandchildren, 1,000 people. This is how you save the world. כמו שכתוב חכמי האמת, as Zohar said, וזה בסוד של, וינצלו את מצרים. It says what? And they made Mitzrayim empty. You know, Jewish nation came out with jewelry, right? And they say, they made Mitzrayim empty. Empty, you know, from what? From the lost souls. Not from money. עשו כמצולה שאין בדגים. They made it as a trap, you know, the fish net. As a net that there is no fish. What does that mean? If you would throw net into Mitzrayim to get some holy sparks, nothing there. Because when Yosef HaTzadik fixed, when Jewish nation came out with Moshe Rabbeinu, all the holy sparks came out. Therefore, they were very careful not to return to Egypt again. Why? There's no more sparks. There's no more lost souls. Everything's cleaned out already. Shum davar tov. There's nothing good remained in Egypt. And that what it means. When Jewish nation came out from Egypt, they came out very rich. Why? They cleaned out all the holy sparks, all the holy souls. Come on. Sheherachnu le'el bimkomo. As we explained later on in Parsha Lech Lecha. The Avim Masechet Pesachim, also in Gemar Pesachim, page Zayin, Amrinan lo higla ele kde sheitosfu kula klum adam zorese. It says in Gemar Pesachim, proof to this, that they didn't come out from Mitzrayim until they collected and gathered all the holy sparks. Vehine, page 87b. Vehine, ikare achana, lenitzotzot, sheit mashchu, mina klipot, asa otam Avraham. Really? Really? First one, the preparation of the cleaning of the sparks to get them closer to himself of these holy souls, who began first?
Avraham
Avinu. Kedichtiv, veta nefesh asher asu b'charan. It says, and Avraham Avinu made souls in Haran. What do you mean made souls? When you see a lost spark and you awaken the spark, you make that spark. You make that soul. You make that person. She'az huchanu kol ha-neshamot ha-atidot le'itgayer. From there, they prepared all the souls that in future generations will convert. And Hashem said, Avraham, they'll be blessed through you. Why? Because later on they'll become Jewish because of you. So they'll be blessed through you. Because of you, they'll be blessed. Hamur ba'Avraham. This was said to Avraham. Mileshon ha-berachot ha'ilan. Shekol agarim, agerim, minan havu v'nit v'notchu. Shekol agerim, minan, havu v'nitchu. Ulchen, Avram giyer giyurim. All these people, they were begging to become Jews, to follow Avraham Avinu, and they couldn't. Until Avraham Avinu came out in the world, and he found the sparks of the souls. And they followed Avraham Avinu, and they became Giyurim. So it says, what Avraham did? Avraham Giyur Giyurim. He would always convert converts. Yitzchak Avu Giyur Giyurim. Yitzchak Avinu also, he made converts. Kedita b'midrash, it says midrash, be'eretz megure aviv. You know Parsha Vayeshev? It says Vayeshev, Yaakov be'eretz megure aviv. And Yaakov lived in the land where his father lived. What do you mean? Megure. From the word giyur. Where father made giyur, he convert people. He also was converting people. So we see from here, Avraham Avinu began converting people. Yitzchak Avinu began converting, continued. And Yaakov Avinu continued converting people. Do you know? One lady, her name was I forgot. She was mother of Amalek. I remember the name.
Timnah.
How?
Timnah.
Timnah, thank you. Timnah came to Avraham Avinu. She said, I want to convert. Avraham Avinu said, I'm sorry, I cannot take you. She came to Yitzchak Avinu. I cannot take you. Yaakov, I cannot take you. So many Jews you take. We cannot take you. Hashem was upset at them. Hashem said, she wants to connect herself to Jewish nation. You don't want to take her? You know what she did? She said, if I want to connect myself to family of Abraham, I will through other way. She got married to Esau. Esau's son, Eliphaz. Esau's son married her, Eliphaz, and came out who? Amalek. If they would convert her, biggest tzaddiki would come out. Because they didn't, biggest Hashem came out. Till today we suffer from Amalek. Hitler, Amalek, Esau.
Also to the
converter. Yeah, exactly. Huh?
Under what grounds didn't they convert her?
Why didn't they?
Because they saw she didn't mean well.
Somebody says the weddings. So why is that a mistake that they did?
Today, we can't just take somebody to come. Somewhere. Like, you know, a boy likes a girl. She says, I want to become Jewish. Where do you want to become Jewish? I want to marry him. What do we say to them?
Not a good idea.
What if she says, I don't care if I marry him. He says no to me even better. I want to become Jewish myself. You know what? It's a mitzvah to kick her out. You have to kick her out. Once, twice, three times. I mean, she still insists, that's a different story. Then you could give her books to sit on. Still, it's not so simple the way we talk. It's not so simple. Rav Wolkin used to tell me, if a goy wants to become Jew, you tell him no, you kick him out 5-10 times, he's going to threaten you. I'm going to kill you if you're not going to do it because I want to become Jewish. Because I want to get myself connected to Torah. That person, he really means it. But today when they say, oh, he embarrassed me, I'm going, bye. Oh, you see, either way, they're doing because to get married. No. Or some people do it, 1-2 weeks they keep Shabbat, they don't keep Shabbat. Waste of time. Wasted, you tell me. Waste everything. Why are you wasting your time? B. Yes.
Let's say they converted, right?
Yeah.
And they hold Shabbat for 2 months, 3 months. After that, they become not religious. They keep kosher now, but they're not religious after that. Does it like, do they count as a goy or they still count as Jewish?
Shabbat is the foundation of Judaism.
That's what I'm saying. They don't hold.
Person them. Doesn't keep Shabbat, there's nothing to talk about. Shabbat is the foundation.
But
I'm not going to go through the details of Alachot Gerim. Is this B'di'avad, L'chatchila? This is not Psak Alacha class. But forget about that. A Jew who was born 1,000 years ago as a Jew doesn't keep Shabbat. It's a big question if there's a law of a Jew or a goy. A wine he pours, from that wine you cannot make Kiddush. Why? Doesn't keep Shabbat. When I don't keep Shabbat, I say, Hashem, you're not the one who created the world. There's nothing to talk about. It's like you saving person's leg, you give him treatment on the leg, but you cut off his heart. Is he going to live?
So you're saying the person...
Is he going to live?
No.
The heart of Jewish nation is Shabbat. Person doesn't keep Shabbat, there's nothing to talk about.
So you're saying if somebody doesn't keep Shabbat, but like as like for their children to grow up and hold Shabbat, like to like become religious, he does like Kiddush on Shabbat, but he doesn't hold Shabbat. Doesn't count or anything that he's saying, or is it just like a waste of time?
Okay. We can make steps rapidly in this shiurim, but I'll tell you one thing. There is a law, it's called Tinok Shenishba. It's like a lost child. He was never in yeshiva, doesn't know what's right, what's wrong. And you could rely on that kiddush at home? Yes. Yes. Can you tell your father or your grandfather or your uncle, who you know, and say, listen, you don't keep Shabbat, I'm not going to do that. No, you're not allowed to do that. This way, you will not come closer to Hashem, your father will not come closer to Hashem, your relative is not going to come closer to Hashem. But if you try to say nicely, is it possible, can I do Kiddush once nicely? Or step by step, you learn carefully, you teach, it's true about what you do, but we learn like this in class, we learn like this in school. No father likes, no mother likes, when you tell them, don't do this, do that. But if you bring it properly, with proper respect, proper approach, and you're happy and they're happy. Be very careful how you speak it out, how you say it. It's very not right the way some people try to act. They're smart people, and suddenly the father says, listen, I don't want you in my house. You want to keep it? Get out of my house. You lose and he loses. The proper way is proper approach. You bring it up nicely. My advice to you, until your father does not go into the level of going to pray and shul, going to shul and pray on Shabbat, don't say a word. Let him hear from the rabbi. Let him hear from somebody else than you. step by step he will come to God. Why? Because if you say something wrong, you might ruin everything. But I'll tell you one thing. As a being rabbi in 18 years in the community, 19 years, I'll tell you, a lot of people become religious. Those who said, I don't believe in nothing, today they keep everything. Give time, explain normally, don't say nothing. Look at person's positive things, what he does. Abba, you do kiddush, thank you. Abba, you made that dime, thank you. You wash hands for bread, thank you. You made bracha, thank you. Not only to fathers goes, to sons also goes this. When you realize good things about your children, they want to do more. You realize good things about your students, they want to do more. What if my father always tells me, you're not good here, you're not good there. I don't want to do nothing, because anything I do, I'm bad. Something wise voice. So be careful, you have to be using your common sense, how to bring the proper approach. Sha'az. Okay, I'm reading the second column from the top, okay? Vehine ikara achana. And we'll finish within 4 minutes. Vehine ikara achana nitzotzot sheit mashchu min hakelipot asa otam Avraham. The real sparks who took Avraham. Vehine anash asher asu b'chanan. Sha'az, hukhanu kol hanshamot ha'atidot leitgayer. Vezeh sod hapasuk nivluchu b'cha kolam. Okay, so all the sparks followed on. Lachen, Avraham gir giurim Yitzchak. Avraham followed giurim Yitzchak. Yaakov Avinu. Okay, umeata Yaakov, last comma on the bottom. Umeata Yaakov shaya yodeh shehalichato leMitzrayim hayta kedeh leesov hanidachim. Yaakov knew, I'm going to Mitzrayim as a magnet. You know magnet?
Magnet.
Magnet. He's coming to get all these lost souls to himself. Connect them out. The best magnet today, when you go to any public school, and you take out Jewish kids out of there. Get them 10 minutes to learn. 20 minutes, 1 hour to learn. For a week. You should know. You have no idea who you're saving. Their children, grandchildren, big rabbis, guys. He brought korbanot to Hashem. Kedei sheiten koach v'siyu lebanav lilaked hakol. Why he brings korbanot to Hashem? Hashem, I'm going to Mitzrayim. Help me to get the most souls to save everybody. Umin ha'raui haya she'omar le'Elohi Avraham. And he said, really, he's supposed to be saying, he was worthy to say. It's proper to say, God of Avraham, she'u davke tiken. V'achin ezer v'siyu l'tziat ha'nidachim b'chlalutam avlotam ha'atidim l'itgayer. And Aaron was the first founder to go and get close to the lost sparks. Ele lefi shegam Yitzchak gir giurim. But since Yitzchak also was converting converts, tala azvachim b'Yitzchak, it says what? I'm bringing sacrifice to God of my father Yitzchak. Lefi shechayav adam b'chvot aviv yoter mizekeno. Because you have to respect your father more than your grandfather. Baruch Adonai Olam, amen, amen. I would like to say thank you for our sponsors to help me to print out Likutei Yosef. These are our first steps. I mean, nobody's perfect. But this book has short drashot for parasha. Why? Because some people, maybe they don't have divrei Torah on the table. So we printed 500 copies to make sure every family who maybe they don't learn so much, they don't learn parashiot, so they should speak some divrei Torah on the table. Thank you. If you need to pick up one book, you could take it. We have a lot of books right now. Thank you. Hashem should bless you.